So what is chemistry? Chemistry is the study of matter and the changes it undergoes. Matter is pretty much everything you deal with on an everyday basis. It is anything that takes up space. Or has volume. And has mass. Matter can come in a variety of forms. We'll talk about that a lot in chemistry, and so we'll focus on that a little bit later. In the meantime, we'd also like to definitely say that chemistry is a science. And so it'd be important to first start talking about science itself. The way I like to think about science is a process of gaining knowledge. Or solving problems using something called the scientific method. So there are a variety of fields that use the scientific method, and they would all be considered disciplines of science. Using the scientific method is perhaps one of the best ways that we can learn about nature, learn about our world, and also solve problems within our world. So let's talk about the scientific method. Scientific method can be thought of as a procedure or following steps. And the first step of the scientific method is performing observations. Okay. Observations, in essence, are a detailed set of notes. About the system you want to study, or the problem you want to solve. So one good example of the scientific method would be if someone were sick. So say I am not feeling good. Of course, I would go see my doctor. The first thing she's going to do is start asking me questions. She would ask me questions about my family history, my medical history, especially if this is the first time I saw her. And then, of course, to try to solve the problem that me being sick is, of course, she would ask me about my symptoms. These are all observations. They're going to help her figure out what's wrong with me and also to solve the problem. So learn new stuff and solve the problem. The next thing, step in the scientific method that's going to be used is forming a hypothesis. A hypothesis is an explanation based on observations. Okay, so if I told my doctor that I was feeling feverish, I was tired, and I had a sore throat. Well, there's a variety of things that she could possibly come up with based on her knowledge and expertise. She might say, I have the flu, or maybe the cold. Or if I'm really feeling tired, she might think I have mono, or because of my sore throat, you might think I have strep throat. These are all possible hypotheses based on the observations that she's made. The next step would, of course, be to figure out which one of these hypotheses is the most correct, and what she's going to then do is, of course, perform experiments. Okay. These are tests to validate, which means prove true, or invalidate, prove false. The hypothesis. Now, in this scenario where I'm sick, there'd be a couple very simple tests to make. Should take my temperature to see if I'm running a fever. If she thought I had strep throat, she might take a culture and see if the bacteria are present. If it's something more serious, might take a blood test to figure out what's going on. All of these are experiments to try to prove the hypothesis true, or invalidate it, or prove it false. At some point in time, those experiments will lead her to a conclusion, in which case now she will have a theory. A theory is an explanation based on experimental results. Or data. And the more data, or the more experimental results you have, the more likely or more confident you are in your theory. So, if my doctor came back to me and said that I don't have a fever, strep test, the culture is negative, she would likely come to the conclusion that I have a cold, and now that would be her theory on what is wrong with me. This isn't always a completely linear process. A lot of times we have to go back and forth between the scientific method, but in essence, we are always going to start off with observations. From those observations, we're going to form a hypothesis. The hypothesis must be testable so that we can perform experiments to determine if it's true or not. Now, here's where, if the experiments are going to validate the hypothesis, that is when we're going to call it a theory, or our explanation based on experimental evidence. If the experiments invalidate the hypothesis, well, we sort of have to go back to the drawing board. We can form a new hypothesis based on our experimental evidence. We might need to go back to the beginning and draw more observations. Or we might just have to do more experiments if the experimental results were inconclusive about our hypothesis. We might have to run more tests to see if the hypothesis is in fact true.